Hello student, how are you? I hope you are very well. Welcome to our YouTube channel, Nanoji Modern School. Today, Standard 6, Subject GE, Chapter Number 3, Pronouns, Reflexive, Relative and Indefinite Pronouns. In the previous video, we just complete Unit Number 2 with exercise. What we learned today? Here, we learn about pronouns. ओके हम यहाँ पे प्रोनाउन सीखेंगे जिसमें थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ प्रोनाउन्स है. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल रिफ्लेक्सिव रिलेटिव एंड इंडिफिनिट प्रोनाउन्स. देन फर्स्ट टॉपिक इज रिफ्लेक्सिव प्रोनाउन्स. और प्रोनाउन्स किसे कहते हैं आप पिछले स्टैंडर्ड में आप सीख चुके हैं, फिर भी यहाँ पे हम फिर से रिविजन के तौर पे ले लेते हैं. रिफ्लेक्सिव प्रोनाउंस जो हमने पिछले वीडियो में मतलब कि पिछले चैप्टर में प्रोनाउंस के बारे में पढ़ा था. पर्सनल प्रोनाउंस, possessive pronouns, demonstrative pronouns and interrogative pronouns. Okay, हमें आगे pronouns में ही जो next level के pronouns है वो है reflexive, relative and indefinite pronouns जो है वो हमें पढ़ना है. Okay, then start the first one, reflexive pronouns. What is reflexive pronouns? Contain the suffix self, contain the suffix self, selves when plural, contain the suffix self, selves when plural. यहाँ पे self और self, selves कब लगाना है हमें, जबकि क्या हो plural. Okay, अगर singular है तो हम क्या लिखेंगे self. In the case example यहाँ पे हम ले लेते हैं कि self किसे कहते हैं. Then first of all I just draw a chart so you can easily understand singular and plural. First person, second person and third person. So I just draw a chart so you can easily understand. Here singular and plural, first person, second person and third person. What is the who is the first person? Then I, you, third person, he, she or it. In a plural, we, you and he, she, both are in a plural, they. The first person, I, here in a singular put over here self when the plural is selves. Then reflexive pronouns I change into myself because is a singular and then this is the plural. Okay, you change into yourself, he changed into himself, she changed into herself, it changed into itself. Then when plural, then we is a plural, that's why we change into ourselves. Our selves. You change into in a plural. Sorry. Yourselves. You change into yourselves. Yourselves. They change into themselves. Themselves. Here, reflexive pronouns contain the suffix self. Self then plural. मतलब कि suffix self जो अगर singular है तो यहाँ पे हम क्या लिखेंगे self. And then in a plural, if the sentence is in a plural, that's why we change into selves. Here, what is the meaning of first person? I change into myself. If the homework is written by myself, मतलब कि मेरे द्वारा, मतलब कि खुद ने किया है. किसने किया है? ये जो homework है, मैंने खुद ने किया है. तो ये दिखाने के लिए हम कौन सा pronouns इस्तेमाल करेंगे? Reflexive pronouns का इस्तेमाल करेंगे. In a first person singular, myself. ओके कि मेरे द्वारा, मतलब कि मैंने खुद ने ये पिज्जा बनाया. I made by myself. I made pizza myself. मतलब कि मेरे खुद से, मतलब कि खुद ने पिज्जा बनाया. Next example, second person, you yourself. मतलब कि अगर मैं आपको कहूँ कि ये जो एक्सरसाइज है आपको खुद को, आपको आपको लिखनी है. किसको लिखनी है? आपको लिखनी है, मतलब कि yourself. जी दिस एक्सरसाइज रिटर्न बाय योर सेल्फ, मतलब कि आपको खुद को ये एक्सरसाइज लिखनी होगी. नेक्स्ट थर्ड पर्सन, ही चेंज इनटू हिमसेल्फ. इफ द सेंटेंस इज इंडिकेट टू बॉय, फॉर द एग्जांपल मयूर राइड अ बाइक हिमसेल्फ. मयूर राइड्स by himself. Okay? मतलब कि ये जो मयूर है वो खुद से, मतलब कि अपने himself, मतलब कि लड़की की बात हो रही है तो यहाँ पे हम क्या लिखेंगे? He change into himself. If the sentence is indicate to girls, मतलब कि अगर हम लड़की के बारे में बात कर रहे होंगे तो क्या रहेगा? Herself. And then it change into itself. मतलब कि अगर हम बिल्ली के बारे में या फिर मंकी के बारे में, डोंकी के बारे में बात कर रहे होंगे तो क्या रहेंगे? इटसेल्फ. एंड देन प्लूरल, देन प्लूरल, फर्स्ट पर्सन इन अ प्लूरल, वी चेंज इनटू आवरसेल्फ. दिस इज आवर ड्यूटी. वी आवर ड्यूटी इज सेव ट्रीज. चेंज इनटू आवरसेल्फ, मतलब कि जो ट्री से उसको बचाना किसकी जिम्मेदारी है? तो हमारी, मतलब कि अवर सेल्स, मतलब कि सबकी है. देन यू चेंज इनटू योर सेल्स. देन फॉर द एग्जांपल दिस एक्सरसाइज यू रिटन बाय योर सेल्स. दिस इज आल्सो योर सेल्फ बट दिस इज अ सिंगुलर, देन दिस इज द प्रूलर. मतलब कि यहाँ पे मैं किसी एक पर्टिकुलर पर्सन को कह रहा हूँ कि योर सेल्फ, तुझे अपने आपसे ही ये होमवर्क करना है. तो दिस इज इंडिकेट टू यू चेंज इन टू योर सेल्फ एंड देन ऑल ऑफ यू. देन दिस इज द प्रूलर एंड देन चेंज इन टू यू, यू इन टू योर सेल्फ. मतलब कि ये आप सबको अपने आप, आपके हिसाब से एक्सरसाइज करनी होगी. एंड देन थर्ड पर्सन, ही शी इट. Ruler is they change into themselves. Okay? मतलब कि अगर they को, मतलब कि indicate to, this sentence is indicate to they change into themselves. मतलब कि तेओ, मतलब कि उसको अपने आप के हिसाब से ही करना होगा. Okay? These are called reflexive pronouns when they refer to the subject of the sentence. The subject may a noun or pronoun. Here, this is myself, yourself, himself, herself, itself, ourselves, yourselves, and themselves. These are called. These are called reflexive pronouns. Reflexive pronouns. When they refer to the subject. To the subject of the sentence. Refer to the subject of the sentence. The subject may be a noun or pronoun. The subject may be a noun or pronoun. Noun or pronoun. Here, if you can understand this, what is myself, yourself, himself, herself, itself, ourself, yourself, and themself. These are called reflexive pronouns. When they refer to the subject of the sentence. मतलब कि ये subject जो मतलब कि जो हमारा subject है उसको sentence में से refer करता है. The subject may be a noun or pronoun. मतलब कि subject कोई भी हो सकता है, noun भी हो सकता है और प्रोनाउंस भी हो सकता है. फॉर द एग्जाम्पल, यहाँ पे हमें एग्जाम्पल दिया गया है. वरुण लुक एट हिमसेल्फ इन द मिरर. फॉर द एग्जाम्पल Varun looked at himself in the mirror. Here, this is the subject. And this is the word indicate to a reflexive pronoun. Because here the subject is a the subject may be a noun or pronoun also. That's why here these sentences indicate to a boy. Third person, he. That's why he changed into himself. Himself. You can see that in the flow chart. So here these sentences indicate to a boy. That's why he changed into himself. And this is the subject. These are called himself called reflexive pronoun when they refer to the subject of the sentence. This is the subject. Reflexive pronouns himself called when they refer to the subject of this sentence. Then, next example, they need to think of themselves when they work. Here, this is the subject. This word indicate to reflexive pronouns. These are called reflexive pronouns when they refer to the subject of the sentence. Here, what is the subject? who is the subject here? The subject is in a singular, plural, they. They need to think of themselves. They change into themselves when they work. Okay, student, here this is the reflexive pronouns. First of all, this write down in your book, then further moving. So student, have you done this? Then, further moving. Next, the choice of the reflexive pronouns will depend on the noun or personal pronoun which goes before it. For example, here the choice of the reflexive pronouns will depend on the noun or personal pronoun which goes before it. The choice of the reflexive pronoun will depend on the noun or personal pronoun which goes before it. For example, जैसे ही हमने अभी चार्ट में देखा था, वैसे ही गोपाल means this word indicate to a boy. मतलब कि ये जो गोपाल है वो कौन है? Boy. Then here reflexive pronoun is a himself. Next example, Radha means here this word indicate to a girl, that's why herself. Here himself and herself is a singular. Then children change reflexive pronouns is a themselves. Children indicate to a plural, that's why this is a plural. Change into they and they into reflexive pronouns is a themselves. I reflexive pronouns is myself. This video is teaching by myself. मतलब कि ये जो वीडियो में सिखा रहा वो कौन सिखा रहा है? मेरे द्वारा. मतलब कि मैं सिखा रहा हूँ. Myself. Reflexive pronouns is a myself. You in a singular. Singular. You change into. मतलब कि you Reflexive pronouns is yourself in a singular. You is in a singular. Reflexive pronouns is a yourself. Next example. You in a ruler. Ruler. You reflexive pronouns is yourselves. They reflexive pronouns is themselves. We reflexive pronouns is ourselves. Me change into new self. It reflexive pronouns is a itself.
मतलब कि जैसे ही हमने चार्ट में देखा था, आपके बुक में इस तरह से दिखाया है, जिससे आपको इजीली समझ में आ सकता है जो हमने चार्ट के द्वारा मतलब कि चार्ट डिवाइड करके सिंगुलर प्लुरल करके हमने डिस्कशन किया था।
Then the word we have looked at here are sometimes used after nouns or personal pronouns to emphasize a point. They are called emphasic pronouns. Here, the words we have looked. We have looked at here. Sometimes used after nouns and personal pronouns to emphasize a point. They are called emphasic pronouns. Here, the words we have looked at here sometimes used after nouns or personal pronouns. मतलब कि ये जो words हम देख रहे हैं, कभी कभार sometimes used, मतलब कि इसका इस्तेमाल किया जाता है after, मतलब कि nouns के बाद में, after nouns और personal pronouns के बाद में, उसे हम क्या कहते हैं, emphasize a point. They are called emphasic pronouns, जिसे हम क्या कह सकते हैं, emphasic pronouns भी कहा जाता है। For the example, यहाँ पे example दिया है, why can't you find your books. You yourself kept them somewhere. मतलब कि ये जो yourself, himself, etc. जो है वो क्या कहते हैं, the words we have looked at here sometimes used after nouns or personal pronouns
टू अ इंफेसिव अ पॉइंट, मतलब कि यहाँ पे नाउंस और पर्सनल प्रोनाउंस के बाद में जो वर्ड्स का इस्तेमाल किया है उससे हम क्या कहते हैं, इंफेसिव प्रोनाउंस। मतलब कि यहाँ पे देख सकते हैं, व्हाई कांट यू फाइंड योर बुक्स, यू योरसेल्फ, मतलब कि पर्सनल प्रोनाउंस और नाउंस के बाद जो इस्तेमाल किया गया है ये वर्ड को, वो हम इंफेसिव प्रोनाउंस के नाम से भी जाने जाता है। मतलब कि समटाइम्स यूज, मतलब कि कभी कभार इसका इस्तेमाल किया जाता है। नेक्स्ट वर्ड, शी हरसेल्फ, शी हरसेल्फ, ये देख सकते हैं आप, दिस सेंटेंस स्टार्ट विथ द शी, शी हरसेल्फ हैज टू स्टडी if she wants to pass with good mark, with good marks. Here next sentence, she herself has to study if she wants to pass with good marks. In the sentence, personal pronouns after the words we have looked at here sometimes used after nouns or personal pronouns. Emphasis a point, मतलब कि emphasis a point, they are called emphasis pronouns. मतलब कि इसे हम क्या कहते हैं, emphasis pronouns. Both sentence nouns or pronouns after using emphasis a point, they are called emphasis pronouns. उसे हम क्या कह सकते हैं, emphasis pronouns के नाम से भी कहते हैं। Okay student, first of all write down in your book, then further move it. So, okay student, have you learned this? Then now, the next topic is relative pronouns. We will teach in our next video. Then, what is your homework? Your homework is write a reflexive pronouns in your rough book, in your rough book. Write a reflexive pronouns in your rough book. What we discussed in this video, you just read it and
writing. So you can easily understand what is reflexive pronouns. Okay, student. Next video we discuss about the relative pronouns. Okay, student. Thank you very much. Have a nice day. Bye.